I believe that every human being has a set of priorities that they live their life by. And whatever is highest on that priority list, whatever is most purposeful and meaningful to them, most important, is what they are inspired to get up in the morning and do. And whenever they do that, they have fulfillment. And everybody, regardless of whether they're conscious of it or not, has that. When they become conscious of it, now they add fuel to fire. And they now become enthused, and people come around to watch them burn with their inspiration. And so the key to this is having a purpose that inspires you. This can make the difference between ordinary life and extraordinary life. So when a person sets goals and objectives that align with that highest value, highest priority, the most meaningful thing in their life, man, that is when they are automatically a leader. That's when they automatically take off. And what's amazing is, if you look in your life, everything is pointing you to that. Everything that you've ever done that inspired you is pointing in that direction. All the things that you do and think about are pointing in that direction. The things you fill your time, your energy, your space, the things you are focused on, the things that you set as goals, there's a common theme to them, and they all revolve around that highest value. The ancient Greeks called it the telos, which meant the end in mind, the thing that's most important to us, the thing that we revolve everything we do around. Once we tap into that, we got the fuel and the vitality and the power to accomplish greatness. It's natural inside us to do that and live that way. When I look back and help people through my years actually identify what that is, it's kind of like an eye-opening thing when they see how their life has been pointing them that way, but they just didn't consciously acknowledge it. Because if you look very carefully, all your mentors that you've ever had in your life, there's a common theme to them. And the ones that actually have left their biggest mark in your life, the thing that's common to them is the thing that's linked to that highest value. All the careers you've done are actually giving you ingredients that it takes to live that highest value and actually fulfill what's most meaningful. The relationships that you had, the things that supported and challenged your life, all the people are actually gearing you as feedback mechanisms to live that highest value. Napoleon Hill in Think and Grow Rich and The Laws of Success called it the chief aim. And when you have your chief aim and you're clear about what you want, you accomplish way more than when people are wandering around aimlessly and subordinating to other people's whims and expectations. They're the followers. But the person who finds their purpose, they awaken their leader. Everybody has it inside. They just haven't acknowledged it and haven't allowed themselves to portray that and live that out in their life. So I wonder what would happen if you got a piece of paper out and write down what you know inspires you, what you know you'd like to do as a contribution to the earth, what you know you'd love to do as a service to earth, and look at what has been consistently in your life an important focus of your life for a period of time, and what you see your life moving you on and actually manifesting gradually and slowly but surely in your life. If you look, you'll see that the entire world around you is actually guiding you to do that. Once you allow that to be the forefront of your mission and your focus, you accomplish more. You live more. You're more vital. You attract more things, more opportunities, more people to help you fulfill that. The people, the places, the things, ideas, and events in your life synchronize around that. That's the natural, the right state of mind for a person. They're designed to live that way, purposefully. It was Viktor Frankl who went through concentration camps back in the decades ago, and in the process of doing it, he found meaning in the concentration camps. When everybody else died, he lived. That's the difference between mediocrity and extraordinary lives, is the people that find that, they have a vitality that allows them to sustain any challenge in the way that they think is in their way of their life. But by having clarity about that mission, you can tackle anything, you can conquer anything, you can be anything, as long as it's in line with that mission. So, identify what is most important to you, write it down, define it clearly, give yourself permission to live it, know that you're going to have people with all different other value systems around you trying to alter that, but allow yourself and give yourself permission to be, do, and have everything you want around that. I started my mission statement and my purpose statement, if you will, when I was 17 years old, 18 years old, and I have been focusing on it and refining it and updating that and literally defining that, redefining that 59 times in the last 37 and a half years. And that is something that if I read, it brings a tear to my eye still to this day, just as it did when I was a teenager. All I can say is that when I define that and I focus on that and I put my energies into that, doors of opportunity open up, and I'm now reaching across the world because of that simple focus, the mission statement, the purpose, the highest chief aim, the most important thing in your life. Identify that, and you've defined your life. I assure you that if you have a purpose in your life that's brought from the unconscious to the conscious and acted upon, you'll empower your life more, you'll achieve more, you'll experience more, you'll have more fulfillment. Your purpose is your life.